Have you ever been confused about the anatomy down there if you're either having intercourse or making love to somebody with a vulva or you own one yourself? Well, I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and today we're going to talk about all you need to know about female anatomy. And make sure you stick around till the end of the video because I'm going to talk about what exactly is this infamous G-spot and what should you know about it. If you're new here, I'm a board-certified urologist, and I make urologic educational content on sexual education, bladder health, and much, much more. So make sure you subscribe and share this video with your friends. The specifics of anatomy, it's important to understand how we develop. For simplicity's sake, in this video, I'm going to refer to anybody with a penis as a male, anybody with a vulva as a female. When a fetus is getting developed in the uterus, so when someone's pregnant and their baby is developing, during the first 8 weeks, we don't have any genitals. The fetus has two distinct things that will eventually develop into either a female or male anatomy, and that is a genital tubercle and a urogenital sinus. At about 10 weeks, the fetus starts developing male or female external genitalia depending on what genes the baby has. So if they're an XX, they're going to develop into a female, and if they're an XY, they're going to develop into a male. The genital tubercle, as you can see here, develops into the head of the penis in the male and the head of the clitoris in the female. Because these structures develop from the original urogenital sinus and genital tubercle that were identical in both fetuses, they will have what's called homologous structures. And what that means is that they're developed from the same embryological tissue. They have very similar function, structure, and location. So in men and women, the head of the penis and the clitoris develop from the same tissues, as well as the hood of the clitoris and the foreskin of the penis. And then when you look at the lips of the labia, or the outer and inner lips of the vagina, and the scrotum is actually analogous or similar to the outer lips of the vagina. And that's called the labia majora. So everything you see in this picture is called the vulva. And then at the top, very top, you see the clitoris. And that is, again, as I mentioned, analogous to the male penis, the head of the penis. And so it's full of tons of nerve endings. And very commonly, stimulation of the clitoris will result in orgasm for women, similar to how men need penile stimulation to have orgasms as well. It has a hood as well. And you can see that's called the prepuce. The prepuce can be covering the clitoris, can be moved back and forth, similar to the foreskin of the penis. Interestingly, sometimes the hood of the clitoris can actually get adhesions or stuck to the top of the clitoris, and in some people this can cause some pain. Before we move on to the other anatomy, let's get a little bit deeper into the clitoris. Interestingly, the word clitoris is actually derived from the Greek word clitoris or kleis, which means key by which one enters the door. Very interesting. The clitoris is exactly identical embryologically to the penis, the head and the shaft of the penis. And while it looks pretty small and you only see a very small part of the clitoris, when you actually look at the entire internal part of the clitoris, and here you can see a picture of it, it's actually quite long and bifurcates, very similar to how the erectile tissue of the penis does. And in fact, when you look at studies where they've actually done anatomical dissections, it is identical to the nerve and the blood vessels to the penis. Similar to the penis, also the clitoris can get enlarged and engorged with blood during an erection and have tumescence, very similar to what happens during an erection in a male. And I described that in my video about sildenafil and tadalafil if you want to learn a little bit more about what happens during an erection for a man. And here you can see that all of this erectile tissue covers the urethral opening and the vaginal opening and goes out to the sides. So that is also right underneath some of the inner lips of the vagina, or the labia minora. And so some people can find those areas to be very sensitive as well. Below the clitoris, you can see the urethral opening. The urethral opening is essentially the end of your pee tube. So your bladder makes urine and it pees out of that pee tube. Below that, you can see the vagina itself. The vagina is a pretty amazing structure. The reason being is that it can change in shape. As you may know, when women have babies, it can get quite large to have the passage of a baby. But similarly, that's what happens during arousal. During arousal, it actually gets wider and longer, up to 3 inches longer when the person is aroused. And then lastly, below all that, you can see the opening to the anus. In women, we always talk about having three holes, the urethra, which is at the very top, then the vagina, and lastly, the anus. So as I've mentioned throughout this video, the clitoris is analogous to the penis. So many, many women need clitoral stimulation in order to orgasm. But a lot of people talk about this thing called the G-spot. So what exactly is the G-spot? It was actually identified in 1940 by Ernst Grafenberg. It's on the top of the vagina, or what we call the anterior wall of the vagina, about 1 or 2 inches inside the vagina. A lot of people describe this as you can feel or find this area by putting a finger in the vagina and using a come hither motion. However, it's not like a magic button that you can actually find and press. It's just an area where there's lots and lots of nerves. Interestingly, right above the vagina in this area is what we call the Skene's gland. And the Skene's gland is analogous or homologous to the male prostate. I've previously talked about prostatic massage and how some people find this to be pleasurable. And similarly, some women may find massage of this area to be pleasurable as well. However, is this G-spot the holy grail? Well, for some women, they are able to orgasm with penetration to the G-spot. But for most women, clitoral stimulation is required for orgasm to happen because, like I've described in this entire video, the clitoris is basically the same sensitivity, the same tissue structure as the male penis. And so women need clitoral stimulation very often in order to reach orgasm. I hope you guys enjoyed this introduction to female anatomy. In my next video on female sexual health, I'm going to be talking about female ejaculation. So make sure you subscribe and don't miss that one. And as always, remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.